Hello, it's Desiree for Ikebana Beautiful, and several weeks ago I was asked by a viewer, let me see your vases and tell me about the specialty of the vases and where you use them for. And I thought that's a good idea. So I have a couple of vases I am using in my videos, and I tell you about what vases I use for what kind of material and arrangements. So I start with these two vases. It's a duo, yeah, not in the same height, and you can arrange with them separately. So one arrangement in this and one arrangement in that, but you can also use them together. And this vases are very useful and good to arrange in. The material is tough, it's thick, it's heavy, and I like the shape of them to use it for my arrangements. So this is really one of my favorite vases to use for my arrangements. And this one, this is also a very good shape to use. In one of my last videos I used this one for a kind of wall arrangement. You can use it to accentuate this shape in the middle, and you can use it also for quite high arrangements and low arrangements, and I think it's very useful, this container, to power your creativity. That's what I would like to say, because of using the shape of the vase. And then maybe I take this one. This one I bought not so long ago, and you can use this shape of vase or container. You can use it as a container too. You can use the shape and the form of the container because of the holes here at the sides. Very good to put branches in and then arrange something, so you have stability on the vase and in the vase to make something. So what you can do also with this kind of very special containers, which are really eye-catching, you can use the shape of the container for your arrangement. So you can get an accent on that container by using it. I think it's very useful for that kind of arrangement. So really a whole different thing than, for example, this one. This one is from marble. It's really heavy, so it's stable on your table. And I think if you begin with flower arranging, this is a really good size because it's not too big, it's not too small. You can use not too big branches with more difficulty maybe, and it has stability in it, and that is also very useful. I think this one is really a good shape for a beginner's florist. And then I go to this beautiful Murano glass. This is a really eye-catching container, and you can use it for really eye-catching arrangements and or arrangements with big flowers. You can put flowers inside and then look inside the arrangement, but you can also make a mass shape of flowers in it, for example, or you can use it for more bigger arrangements. This is more difficult than arranging in this kind of vases because of the shape. The shape is more difficult. And then this container of glass, this vase of glass. Glass is always beautiful, but a little bit difficult because you see everything what's in the vase. You can make an arrangement, especially to use that glass and to look at the whole arrangement in and out of the glass, but sometimes it's difficult to make it beautiful, and therefore for a glass vase or container is more difficult to use than ceramic one. This one is a big vase and therefore it's more difficult because you have to measure your arrangement on the vase. Your arrangement has to be big because your container is big. And that's the same thing with this one. This one is also a big vase and therefore it's more difficult to use, and you have to arrange bigger in it. Bigger flowers or bigger branches, longer branches, and therefore this one is more difficult to arranging than, for example, this two and this one. So this is just a start of my container collection. Maybe I make a video about all my containers and tell you the differences about that. But this is the start, and I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed it, and see you next week then. Bye bye.